Surely you've heard of sustainability. It's about living in a way that our environment can sustain us and not living in a way that depletes the world's resources and makes the world less habitable and ultimately uninhabitable for future generations who are your children and grandchildren. But are you living in a sustainable way? Or do you know how to? Well, I don't know where you live, because depending on where you do live, a sustainable life means different things. But let me just generalize and leave you with a challenge. At this very moment, the global picture is that what humanity takes from our planet exceeds the planet's ability to replenish itself by 50%. In other words, our 7 billion world population is consuming what it takes 1.5 Earths to provide. And I'm sure you've noticed that we only have one Earth planet. And you don't need to be a mathematician to figure out that humanity is in for hard times. So you may well ask, then how do things go on? Let me give you an example. Say you have a lump sum of money in the bank, and you're getting interest, and you're living off that interest. That sustainable living. Your capital investment remains, and you live off what it earns. As much as you earn, that's your standard of living. But, and here's where things get messy. If you want to live beyond your means, beyond your bank interest, then your only recourse is, that's right, you start to deplete your capital. In addition to your earnings, you take from your principal. And that way you can increase your standard of living for some time. But at a certain point, you will have depleted your investment to the stage where first your cash in hand and your standard of living go down. And when there's no more to take, then you are bankrupt and you're out on the street. Similarly, for some time, we can take from the earth more than it can replenish, but at a certain point, we will see diminishing returns until there's nothing left, until there's neither food nor water, what to speak of the luxuries of life. So if you're interested in a sustainable life, one in which you don't consume more than the global supply, then research the ample information available on the subject and try to adjust your life accordingly. And now, here's my challenge. If on average we're overshooting global supply by 50%, see how you can decrease, that's right, how you can decrease your lifestyle by 50%. Instead of moving into that bigger house, stay in your smaller home. It's cozy. Or instead of buying a new car every 3 years or whenever you have the funds, use public transport. Really creative. Living like that may not be easy at first, or even the most comfortable, but you will have a clear conscience. A clear conscience that at least you have not contributed to the destruction of our only means of existence. Are you up to the 50% challenge?